Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we will be taking a look at the while loop in Python. So basically the difference between the while loop and for loop is that if we know the number of iterations or the number of repetitions of a certain loop, then we use for loop, and if we don't know the number of iterations, then we use prefer while loop. So let's get started. Open the Python IDLE and press Ctrl plus N for the new file. So first of all, I will just give you the basics of while loop. Let's say if I say I equals 0 and then I say while true, and then it should print I, and this I is equal to I plus 1, which means I'm going to increment this I by 1. So basically if I run this now, this true condition means that this while loop will run an infinite time. So basically this I, which I have initialized as 0, this will keep incrementing by 1. So it will be like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and up to so on, like it will never stop. So let's run this. Just press F5, give it a name and run this. You can see now the while loop has started and this will run infinite times. So basically you can see we are now at 1400 1500. So basically this is really a fast way of creating random numbers, and that's why the while loop is preferred if we don't know the number of iterations. So you can see we have like already have about 4000 iterations now here. So this is just the basics. And if I type here while false, what does this false mean now? False means that this condition is never going to run, because the condition inside this while loop is saying this, that whatever is inside this while loop body, this is false. So if I run this now, nothing will happen at all. You can see now the program just terminated, and its output is blank because the condition is not meeting here, and that is saying false condition here. And now let me just give you a little bit of the choice input here. So let's say if I define a variable here, let's say I should call it a. If I say a equal, and this is an integer type, and also this is an input type, so I say input, and let's say this is saying enter a number. And now based on this a which I have defined here, I am going to condition this while loop. So how can I do it? Let's say if I say that while false, let me just remove this. If I say that a, if a equal 2, then it should just print me the value of I, which is 0, and let's run this. So basically if I enter 2 here, this condition will be satisfied and this while loop will execute. Run this now, you can see that this is saying enter a number. So if I enter 2 here, you can see the while loop started, and it is the same infinite loop which I created previously, you can see. And if I enter anything other than 2, then this condition is not satisfied and there is a false while loop. And whatever is inside this while loop, then if this condition is not satisfied, then this will not run at all. So let's say if I enter anything other than 2, let's say if I enter 5, so you can see the loop just terminated and nothing happens. There is a blank output, the same as previous one. And now let me just give you the concept of list here as well. So if I, let me just define a list here, I should call it B, and that list contains 1 2 3 4 and 5. And now let's say if I say that this condition is equal to 2, then they should print me the values of this list one by one an infinite number of times. That is what a while loop do. So let's say if I just change this print I here to, let's say I should say print, and this is the B list, and this is basically B of 0, B of 1, B of 2, B of 3 and B of 4. So basically this list B is this is the B of 0 element, let's actually just type it here as well. Let's say that this one is b of 0. Okay, b of 0 here is equal to 1, and b of 1 is equal to 2. So this means that this is the index. So basically on the 0 index of this list is this 1 here, and on the first index of this list b is 2, just as here. So let's say I should say print is a b of 0, okay, and then let's say in the next line I should just copy this from here and just paste it again. There are 5 entries, so I should just paste it 5 times. So this will just print me here b of 0, here b of 1, b of 2 is here, b of 3 and b of 4. So now basically this will run only if this condition is satisfied. Like if I enter this a equal to 2, then this will print me all the values or all the elements in this b list, which is 1 2 3 4 5, and this will just do this process an infinite number of times because the while loop condition is satisfied. So let's try this. If I run this now, look at this, this is saying enter a number. So let's say if I say the number is 3, so nothing will happen. Why? Because this condition is saying a equal 2, which is not satisfied if I enter 3 here. So if I enter this, there will be a blank output. You can see here this is saying a blank output, like the code is executed and nothing happened. And if I enter 2 here, let's say I should enter 2. So now you can see the loop has started, and what it's doing is basically, if I show this to you side by side, so basically you can see if I start this right side, you can see this is printing 1 2 3 4 5, which is the whole list b, and again this is printing 1 2 3 4 5. This means that this while loop is printing the b list an infinite number of times. So if I start it again, you can see this is saying 1 2 3 4 5, 1 2 3 4 5, and up to infinity. This loop will never stop. So this is what basically a while loop do. And let me just give some more detail of this list, and that how can you use it in many other ways. So let's say if I define another list here, let's say I should call it C1, and then there C1 basically contains that A, B, C, D and E. So now I have two lists. What I can do here is that basically I can print these both lists at the same time using this print here. So let's say I should just, how can I do it? Let's say just add a comma here and then add the plus sign and again comma, and then I want to print these both lists at the same time. So basically this list is C1. So if I say C1 of 0, so this means A, and if I say C1 of 4, this means E. So let's say I should say call it as C1 of 1, and just let me just copy this from here for my easiness and just paste it here in this comma as well. Same goes here and here and here as well, and add these commas as well. So now you can see here that if this b of 0 is printed, then at the same time this c1 of 0, this is c1 of 1, c1 of 2, c1 of 3 and c1 of 4. So this means that if this b of 0 is printed, then c1 of 0 is printed at the same time. So basically b of 0 is 1 and c1 of 0 is a. Same here, b of 1 is 2 and c1 of 1 is b. You can see it like basically this is the b list and this is the c1 list. And let me just remove this from here and just add it here. The same goes here as well and here as well. So now basically if this b of 0 is printed, at the same time c1 of 0 is printed. So b of 0 is 1 and c1 of 0 is a. Similarly b of 1 is 2 and c1 of 1 is b. So let's say if I run this now, and this loop will only run if this condition is satisfied. That is a equal to. So if I enter a equal to, this means that loop is being executed, and you can see what this is printing is the same as I have coded here. So basically, if I stop this, you can see at the right side, it is saying, let's say 1 plus a, 2 plus b, 3 plus c, 4 plus d, 5 plus e. And this list is basically, and this loop is basically continued an infinite number of times, because this is a while loop. So like, these are some basics of how can you automate the lists, or how can you print a number of lists using while loop. And now let's move toward the next concept. And that next concept is the nested while loop, that how can you use a while loop inside a while loop. So let's say if I change this to, let's say I should say that a not equal to 1. So this means that if I enter anything else than this 1, then this loop will be executed. And if I enter 1, then this loop is never going to execute, and this will be a false condition if I enter 1 here. So let's try this. Let's see, if I enter 1 here, you can see nothing is happening, because this condition here is not satisfied. This is saying a must not be equal to 1. And if I enter 1 here, then there is a blank output. So let's say for the nested while loop, I should define another while loop here. Inside this while loop, I am defining another while loop. So let's say that have the condition that a must not be equal to, let's say 2, and then close this. And let's say if just print this list in this case, so let me just remove this from here, and we can do it. Let's say remove this, remove this, remove this, and this as well, and just close this one, and close this all again. So let's say I want to print here that print me the C1 list. So I can do it easily by, if I say print C1 of, let's say 0, and then close this. And then let me just copy this from here and paste it 5 times, as I have 5 elements in this C1 list. And this is C1 of 0, C1 of 1, C1 of 2, C1 of 3, and C1 of 4. So basically, this is the same list as I have created here. This C1 of 0 is A, and this C1 of 4 is E. So let's say I have defined a while loop with a condition A not equal to 2 inside a while loop with a condition A not equal to 1. So basically, this loop, this while loop is controlling all these loops. Even if there are several while loops, this first one is called the master loop. So basically, this loop's condition is going to control whatever is nested inside this mastered loop. So let's say if I run this now, let me just run this so it will be more clear to you. And here also, I equal I plus 1. And you can also do it like, if I say I plus equal 1. So this means the same as I equal I plus 1. So based on your choice, how can you use it. And then if I run this code, and let me just show it to you side by side here, you can see now this is saying enter a number. So if I enter 1 here, the same thing will happen, nothing will be printed here. So let's say if I say 1, you can see the loop is executed and nothing happened, like there is a blank output. And let me just run this again, and this time let me just enter, if I enter 2 here, let's say if I enter 2, So basically, this condition is not satisfied. So what will happen is that it will just print me this B of 0, B of 1, B of 2, B of 3, and B of 4, which is this B list, which is from 1 to 5. So if I enter 2 here, you can see this is now printing me from 1 to 5, 1 to 5, and infinite number of times. And this is the B list. So this means that I have entered 2 here, which means that this condition is not satisfied. So when the loop just comes here, so basically it will just give me the output of this loop, like nothing will happen inside this loop because this condition is not satisfied. And let me just make it more complex by creating another list here. Let's say I should call it C2. Let me just copy this from here and just paste it. This list is C2, and let's say this is A1, B1, this is C1, D1, and this one is E1. I have just added this one to make it a little bit different from this loop, from this list. And then let's say I should just copy this all from here, and then inside this while loop I am creating a third nested while loop. So if I paste it here, I will just show it to you that, let me just make some spacing here, and let me just change the condition to 3. And now this one is C2, this list is C2, so I should just change these all C1 to C2, C2 here as well. Okay, and now what will happen is basically, if I want to run this loop, this while loop, and I want these both while loops to not to be executed, so I can do it by entering something greater than 3. So let's say if I enter 3 here, basically this condition is not satisfied, and then this loop will run and this will print me C1, and C1 is basically this A, B, C, D, E. So just let's try this. Press F5. If I show this to you side by side here, let me just make it here. I told you if I enter 3 here, so basically the second while loop will be executed, and this will just give me the print of C1, and C1 is basically A, B, C, D, E. So if I enter 3 here, you can see here, this is now giving me the outputs of A, B, C, D, E, and these outputs are the, and these elements are basically the elements of C1. So basically this loop is being executed and this loop is not. Why? Because I have entered 3 and this condition is not satisfied. Similarly, let's try this again. Let's say if I want to run this while loop, this mastered while loop, so I should make this condition false. This condition is saying that A is not equal to 2, and if I enter A equal to 2, then this while loop will be executed and these while list will not be executed. And if I show this to you side by side here, let me just make it side by side, and if I enter 2 here, this will just run the first while loop, and there is B list, and B is from 1 to 5. If I enter 2 here, I am making the condition of second while loop false. If I enter this now, you can see this is now printing from 1 to 5 an infinite number of times. So these are the basic concepts of the while loop and nested while loop. And let me just show you one thing again, that let's say if I want to run this loop, what can I do here? Basically I have to enter something greater than 4, greater than 3. So let's say if I enter 3, if I enter 4 here, let me just enter, let's say if I enter 4 here, this means now this is printing A1, B1, C1, D1 and E1, which is basically the list C2 I have created. So this means that now these two loops are not running, and this third while loop is this condition is satisfied and this while loop is being executed. So this is how you can basically execute one while loop while keeping the other loops not executed. The basic concept of while loop and nested while loops in Python, and see you next time.